guys, what's up? Oh. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. For those of you who do not know who I am, my name is Emily Stevens, and today I will be bringing you a kind of a drugstore haul from Ulta. It's not really a haul, it's just new things that I found in the drugstore department of Ulta. If you want to see how I created this look with all of those new products, then please stick around. The first product that we're going to be talking about today is the Rimmel Blending BB Cream 9-in-1 Skin Perfecting Super Makeup. So it's not completely brand new, but they just did redo the formula, so now it's like a water-based formula. So the 9 is supposed to, I've never used this product at all, like not even the old formula. So the 9 things that it's supposed to do is prime, moisturize, help minimize the appearance of pores, conceals, covers, smooths, mattifies, brightens, and helps protect, lasts all day. All right, let's go ahead and try it. So I got shade light medium. I'll just squeeze a little bit back there. And then I got brand new beauty blender, or not beauty blenders, but beauty sponges from Ulta. I got this little baby one. I've actually used this once, but I haven't used the big one. No. Yes, I have. Just kidding. I use them both, but I really like them. The density of them is pretty comparable to the beauty blender, like the actual beauty blender. I'm just going to dot this all over my face. Smells like sunscreen. Like, it has a hint of a sunscreeny type of a smell. I hope that I don't need any. Okay. Alright, so I'm just gonna take this beauty sponge and dot it all in. Okay, so my first impression is that this is definitely very light coverage, but it is a BB cream. So if I was just having like a lazy day and I was just gonna like throw this on and nothing and just put powder over it and go, it'd be perfect. But I would never use this to conceal anything because, yeah, but I think for a primer, it would be good. Okay. Maybeline Dream Cushion Fresh Face Liquid Foundation on the Go. And I got Classic Ivory Shade 20. This is it. And when you open it, it comes with its little spongy guy. Okay, and then it comes and you have to just pull this little thing off. And there's the cushion. So let me read the instructions. So I've seen this all over the internet. Press thing on the sponge, pat on face, blend using small taps. All right, let's try this. But I think they just released some new shades too, so that's why it was in the new section again, but I've never tried it, so I'm excited. Oh god, this may be too dark for me. Oh, whatever. Here we go. I like the mirror that comes with this. Slightly darker than my skin, but that's okay. I could fix that. I think once it settles, it'll probably be the right color. Putting a little on my eyes. I don't know how I feel about this little thing. I like the foundation, but I don't know how I feel about the little spongy guy that comes with it. I may be the only person that doesn't like it. That's okay. Oh, okay. So it was really because it was the way that I was holding it, but I like it. I see why everybody really likes this foundation. The coverage is pretty good. It's pretty easy to build also, which I'm liking. I feel like my arm's getting a workout doing this. OK.
Okay, let's bring her on down to the neck. We're just gonna swipe.
All right. Okay, so the next step. So I got this new Master Camo, or Maybeline Master Camo color correcting kit. And it's also a contour kit. I got shade 100 light. This is what it looks like. Hold on, if I can get the sticker off of this thing. I should have done this before, you know? Let's open her up. Oh, so she comes with a little brush. Oh, the brush is actually soft, but I don't know if I would ever really use the brush. Anyway, so let's see what it says. So step one, correct. Green visibly reduces redness. Yellow brightens. Step two, conceal. Conceal imperfections or under eye dark circles. Step three, highlight. Brighten face and eye area to enhance features. Cool. So then it has like the, it says correct, conceal, and then highlight under there. So that's cool. So if you had no idea what you were doing, then that would be perfect for you. The concealer first. I'm just going to take my little beauty sponge, my little baby one, and conceal my under eye area using this. I don't know how much I like this concealer. It's like a very light concealer. I think strictly for contouring this would be a good color, but I think that I would have to put another concealer on over it because you can still see the bags in my eyes and everything under it, but I think for contouring purposes, this would be a good product to use. I just am not liking it for my, like, actually concealing my under eye area. Okay, so I'm gonna just contour my face a little bit using this darker color here under the conceal area. Oh, okay, wow. Is there like... I don't know how I feel about this product. That makes me so sad. Okay, so I don't like this. I think I will like the green and the highlighter, but the concealer, oh, and the banana, I'll probably use that color too. So this side and this side I'll like, but I don't like the concealing part of it because, as I said before, you could just see all of my bags still, and that's just not okay. So yeah. I'm going to try this little highlighter, this one down here, on one side of my cheek. Is there any highlight there compared to the other side? No. Okay, so this is a flop. I don't like this. Let me see about the green on my hand. That's what the green looks like on my hand, and then let me use another clean finger for the banana. And then that's the banana. So those two will probably be good. I don't want to use them right now because I did put other makeup on my face. Other than that, though, I do not think I will recommend this product to you. If you're looking for a good color corrector, I would get it. There's a billion other color correctors out there. NYX makes a really good one. The Ulta brand, if you go to Ulta to buy your drugstore makeup, they make a good one. I just wouldn't recommend this personally. So yeah, that makes me really sad because I had high hopes for it. I'm gonna go ahead and use my Revlon ColorStay concealer and just conceal over where I put that product. The next product that I did get, which is another liquid product, it's from NYX. It's called Away We Go Liquid Highlighter. Hi, it's so cute. I'm so excited about this. So let's see what it says. Daytime Halo. Cool. So I got shade HWN81W. Just kidding. Daytime Halo AWG06. That's the color, I think. It's like, okay, so there's like a straight gold one, which I almost got, but this one's like a little bit more, I don't know. It's just a little bit more like, it's not as gold. Let me swatch this on my hand. That's what it looks like. Oh my god, it's like liquid gold. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this. So I'm gonna try two things. I'm gonna try to do this right here. And then afterwards, I'm going to I'm gonna put my makeup, the rest of my makeup on, and then on this side, I'll put this on top of the other makeup to see that if it reacts weirdly sitting on top of makeup. Cause sometimes that will happen with a liquid product like this, in my personal experience. Ooh, but I really like this. It has a good payoff. It's not super like heavy at all, which I like, and it just glided on. It's super creamy, and like as you can see that it's like really pigmented. And I think it was less than $5, so I think. Don't quote me on that. I will put the price of this down in the description bar. Okay. So I'm gonna go ahead and just set my face with my e.l.f. powder. Just because I didn't buy a new powder. Is anyone else suffering from like crazy allergies right now? Because I am. And this morning, my parents like woke me up at 7 a.m. and were like, oh my God, come downstairs and get in the pantry. There's tornadoes. I was like, okay. So I went down and had to sit in the pantry on the floor for like 30 minutes. Yeah, they're nuts. Okay, so I got two, and I'm not gonna do that now. I'm gonna do the eyebrow product that I got. NYX just came out with a 3-in-1 brow product, and they had a billion colors. Like they had so many color options. So this is what the packaging looks like. It's cute. It's got define, fill, and set. You can see those. So this is what it looks like. Let's see. So we have that. That is the first one. I'm confused. What just happened? Oh, and then that unscrews. Okay, so don't pull that. Listen to it. Okay, so let's redo this. Okay, so here's how you open it. You pull the top off, and there's the first step. And then you unscrew this, and then there is that. Oh, sorry, that. And then I'm assuming, okay, so you screw off the end and there is the setting. Cool.
When I was 6 years old, I broke my leg. And I was running from my brother and his friends. Tasted the sweet perfume of the mountain grass all rolled down. I was younger then.
Huh. I like that. I'm a fan. Got two new eyeshadow palettes. This one is from Maybeline. It's the 24 Karat Nudes palette. And I've actually used this once before because I didn't know it was new. So I have a tutorial coming soon for you guys of this. And this is what all the shades look like. I will swatch a few of them for you if you'd like me to. I'll do this pretty gold color. And then this purple.
And then, what other color should I do? I'm trying to do ones that'll show up on my skin. I'll do this brown. Okay, so there's the gold, purple, and then the darker brown. I like it. So it's mainly a shimmery, no. It's got a nice mix of matte and shimmers. They're all pretty pigmented. I like them. They work really easily on the brow. I can tell you, or on the brow, on the lid. I can tell you that from experience because I have used this. So I'm not going to use this today. I'm going to use the other palette, which I just picked up today at Ulta in the drugstore section. It's from Revolution Makeup, Revolution London. Unicorns Unite. Isn't this so cute? Look at the like holographic packaging. So yeah, we're super pumped about this. Okay. Let's see if I can open this. Okay, so this is what the palette looks like. And then let's open her on up. Oh wow, she comes with a really big mirror. I just took the plastic off. That is what she looks like. Oh, hey, camera. and she comes with this big little brush thing. Wow, these colors are cute. I really like these. Okay, I'm gonna swatch a few. Which one should I swatch? I'm gonna swatch this matte blue one, or turquoisey kind of a color. Oh, wow, that's pretty. That's what it looks like. And then I'll do this orange color, because how could I not, right? This is a shimmer shade. So it looks like there's a mix of mattes and shimmers. So that's just one swatch right there. Okay, and then I'm gonna do this black match. Or actually, we'll do the pink one. We'll do the pink matte shade. Or it's like a purpley, it's like a lilac-y kind of a color. That's what she looks like. And then, ooh, this grape, like sparkly one. I can't not do that. I'm into the grays. Although I'm like a warm-toned girl, I like grays. I really like gray shadows. She's pretty. They're pretty. Okay. So I'm going to work with these today on my lids. So I decided to go ahead and just speed this part up because you don't really care. I mean, I overall really like the product. I think that for being $10, it was an amazing product. It gave you a lot of shimmery shades and a lot of mattes, and it's a good kind of fun palette to have. They also had this palette in like, or this brand also makes neutral palettes and other stuff like that. And I'm interested to try those out so I can give you my opinions. Overall, however, I really did enjoy this product. So yeah, sorry, I keep like hiccuping. Anyways, I really enjoyed this, like I've said 15 times now, so you're probably like, Emma, shut up. Yeah, okay, I'm gonna shut up. And so yeah, here's the music. Talk slow and come over and start up a conversation with just me, and trust me, I'll give it a chance. Now take my hand, stop and the man on the jukebox, and then we start to dance, and now I'm singing like, girl, you know I want your love, your love was handmade for somebody. Away we glow. Highlighter on this side. I don't know if you can see it more so. Yeah, see, you can see that it's glowing. And it's not. So I'm going to put this on top of all of my makeup over here just to see how that will set on it. See if there's any change or any way that it weirdly reacts with any of the formulas that I have on underneath, like any of the blushes or powder. I forgot to show you guys the brush with this. It's like a really cool brush. It's like kind of like it's a doe foot, but it's wider and flatter. So if you wanted to just like stick some on your hand or something, so then you could mix it in with your foundation or something else. Okay, so it doesn't seem to be being weird or anything. The last thing that I need to do is my lipstick. So this is not new on the market, but it is something that I just purchased. It's the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in shade
SMLCO5. That's what it is. It's like a nice little rosy kind of a color. So let me just get a mirror and I will apply it.
Grab on my waist and put that body on me. I'm coming now, follow my lead. I'm coming now, follow my lead. Mm-hmm. I'm in love with the shape of you. We push and pull like a magnet do. Although my heart is falling too. I'm in love with your body. Last night you were in my room. And now my bedsheets smell like you. Every day discover.
I like her. Maybe not this two combination together, but I do like it. I think it's pretty. Okay, and then I just got this new Ulta Beauty matte setting spray. So I'm going to go ahead. Okay. Alrighty, so that is it for this, my haul of all the new what's new at the drugstore, plus a few extra little things here and there. But yeah, overall good. I really like the BB cream as a BB cream. I don't think that it would work as a to conceal, but it's really not matte either. So, but I liked it, so I will use this again. I really did not like the Maybelline Master Camo. No, not a fan. Like, really not a fan. Like, maybe I used it wrong, so if I did and you know, let me know down in the comments, because I would for sure like to know that. But not a fan of this. I really, really like the 24 Karat Nudes and the Revolution Makeup Revolution, what is this, the Unicorn Unite Palette? Oh, this says Salvation Palette. Unicorns Unite. Okay, cool. I was like, wait, did they put something else? Anyways, I really liked these. I really, really liked the NYX new brow, the Trio 3-in-1 brow pencil. And I really liked this as well as the Dream Cushion. So I really liked all of these products. There was only one that I did not like, and that was the Maybelline Color Correcting Highlighting Concealing Palette. I will probably like the Color Corrector and the banana powder, which is also a color corrector. But as for the rest of it, I just think that you might as well spend your money on something else. NYX makes a great one, like I said, so I would go with that or an Ulta one. But yeah, so those are my overall impressions. All right, guys, that is it. You just heard my final thoughts about it. I would go ahead and purchase all of it minus that one color corrector palette from Maybelline. But maybe it'll work for you. Just because it didn't work for me doesn't mean that it won't work for you. Please give this video a big thumbs up if you liked it, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will be posting new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. And I'll try to get a fourth video out to you every week, but it'll kind of just happen sometimes and not other times. Any videos that you want to see on this channel or you want to see me do, then please let me know down in the comments section. Everything that I used in this video will be down in the description box, and all of the new products will have the price next to it. I hope you guys have a fabulous day, and I can't wait to see you guys again soon. Bye!